Welcome. Today, we try to learn the laws of singing. What does the Halacha say about singing during the year and at the time of Sfirat HaOmer and Ben HaMetzarim? Singing and hearing music. Let's start with the Gemara that explains that one may not hear music. The following it says, "Mishebatla Sanedrin batel hashir bebatei mishtarot." When Sanedrin wasn't operating anymore, the Chachamim restricted hearing music in places that you drink wine. Sheneemar bashir lo ishtu yain. Once you sing, you shouldn't drink wine at the same event. Therefore, from here, Chachamim learned that one is not allowed to hear music while he's drinking wine. The Gemara says more than that in Gittin Daf Zayin. The Gemara says, Shalchu lemaruk vabarchama, zemer minayin lanu shasur. How do we know it's forbidden to hear music? The Gemara says, a pasuk, Shalach lehem sheneemar al tismach Yisrael al gil ka'amim. A Jew is not allowed to rejoice just like the goyim do. That's what the goyim do, and therefore it's restricted. The Gemara says, why don't you learn from a different pasuk? The pasuk says, Bashir, lo ishtu yain. When you sing, you shouldn't drink wine. The Gemara says, because from this pasuk I learn only with musical instruments, but without musical instruments, just singing in the mouth, that's the first pasuk is teaching me, and that's what the Gemara wants to teach me. That once you sing in the mouth, you're not allowed to drink wine at the same event. Comes out like this. The Mishnah Berurah explains that there's two laws here. One law is if you're drinking wine, don't sing at all. Unless we're talking about drinking wine at parties of mitzvah, like for instance, weddings, bar mitzvah, Shabbat. But obviously, those times, one is allowed, as we're going to see soon. Otherwise, when a person just goes to drink for his enjoyment, at that time, he shouldn't sing for his enjoyment. But hearing musical instruments, that's forbidden even without drinking. And therefore, comes out from this Gemara, as many Achronim learn, that today is forbidden to hear music. But if we look at the Rishonim, they don't quite learn like that. If we look at the Meiri, brought down at Yechaveh Dat, he says, Kol mine zemer ha'asuim lenagen bahem lesimchat holelut, ve'en bahem kavana leshabeach et habore itbarach ulecad mitzvah, אלא דרך קלות ראש ותענוג במיני מאכל ומשתה, אסור לשומעם ולהשתעשע בהם. The Meiri explains the following. Meiri was the Rishon, he explains the following. He says, when is it forbidden to hear musical instruments? It's only when one is making himself happy, simchat olelut, such a happiness that has no place in Torah. It's a low kind of happiness. And therefore, such a thing, in such an event, you're not allowed to hear music. But otherwise, music would be allowed. If a person especially hears it for a mitzvah, a certain event, like we sang before, a certain party of a mitzvah, siyum masechet, or so on, such a time would be allowed to hear music. And that would be something that Chachamim didn't restrict. More than that, says Rav Gaon, that he says that Rav Huna, the Gemara, that explained about Rav Huna says that Zemer shel umanei burseki would be not allowed. That's the only thing that's not allowed. Why? Because he saw that Zemer shel umanei burseki, they took the music and they heard things that are not allowed to hear. Some words that were not kosher words. And therefore, such music will be forbidden. But says Rav Haigon, at any time that the music is kosher, it's fine. As long as the music isn't kosher, you're allowed to hear. So according to that, you have two poskim over here that would allow us to hear, especially if it's a Jewish song, it's Jewish words, it's praises to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, the Meiri allows it, and the Rav Haigon allows more than that, as long as there's no words that are not kosher in the song, one may hear such a thing. Now, although we're saying that those Rishonim and Chacham Ovadia points out that Tosfot and Rashi also there allow hearing music as long as it's not hearing it together with drinking wine, and all that will be allowed. But the Achronim didn't agree with such a thing, and they want to forbid hearing music altogether. Like, for instance, the Magen Avraham even goes further. He says that one not allowed to sing in the mouth songs unless it's on Shabbat, and he sings the Zmirot Shabbat, songs of Shabbat. Otherwise, even on Shabbat, other songs are not allowed. And therefore, according to many Achronim, one is not allowed to hear music. But what should we do, lehalacha? Lehalacha, say Rav Moshe Feinstein, Rav Eliashiv, Chacham Ovadia, Rav Or Lezion, that today the minhag became that it's mutar. You can see all over, people hear music. As long as the music is kosher, and even more so, if the music is Jewish music, that's fine, one is allowed to hear it. And that became already the minhag. Rav Eliashiv says that that's already the minhag, and so does all the other poskim I mentioned before. The minhag is to allow hearing music. But one should know that once you hear music, you need to know the following. Music is allowed, but you have to have few restrictions. For instance, a man is not allowed to hear woman singing. Woman singing would be forbidden, especially if the man knows the woman, he saw her picture, he saw how she looks, that the achronim don't allow. Secondly, obviously, as we explained, that the words should be kosher words. But even when the kosher words, it's only allowed when it's words of praising to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, but not if it's words of Divrei Torah. Today, there's a custom that they take words from the Torah and they make song out of it. That's not allowed because the Halacha says, brought down in the Mishnah Berurah, and it's a Gemara, that the Torah screams, she cries to HaKadosh Baruch Hu, she comes in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and she says, Asuni Banecha Keklei Zemer, they take me, the Torah Kedosha, the holiest thing in the world, and the Torah wears sack clothing. She comes in front of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, she says, look at this, they're making fun of me, they're making songs out of me. That's a wrong thing. Therefore, such a thing will be forbidden. More than that, the Mishnah Berurah brings from the Taz, that they take the song, or they take the words of Itgadal v'Itkadash, the Kaddish, and they make songs out of it. That's also something that's not allowed. That's forbidden. It says mamash like this in the Mishnah Berurah. The Mishnah Berurah says, as a Seudot Nagim Leshorer Kaddish Dainu Itgadal, people take the words of Itgadal v'Itkadash, Zehu Vaday Chet Gadol. That's a sin. Lo Itiru Ela Zichron Chasdei Hashem. The only thing you're allowed is to praise HaKadosh Baruch Hu, although that's also words of praising. Depends what your intention. If your intention is to praise HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that's one thing. But if you mean for the beep, for the good time that you're getting singing that song, that will be forbidden. So therefore, we learned over here an important law once we get to songs. We need to know what is the intention of a person singing. If the intentions are positive intentions to praise HaKadosh Baruch Hu, that we can say that the minhag allows. But if the intention is to have a party, to have a good time, to just enjoy the song, such a thing should be not allowed. Therefore, one should pay attention to what he's hearing and the way he's singing. That's when we're talking about generally during the year. Now, we try to understand what's the halachot concerning this time of Ben HaMetzarim and Sfirat HaOmer. As you know, that today, at that time, we don't listen to music. The reason for that is not written anywhere in the Shulchan Aruch. One would look in the Shulchan Aruch any place. If the Shulchan Aruch doesn't say that one should not hear at those times music, doesn't say that anywhere. Rather, where do we learn this from? The Magen Avraham says that one is not allowed to dance at the time of those times. Those times one is not allowed to make dancings. And the reason for that is because when a person gets up on his feet and he starts dancing, he has a lot of happiness, he has simcha. Therefore, such a thing, he said, is forbidden. But that thing that is forbidden, he doesn't mention music, the achronim afterwards come and they say, if that's forbidden, music is definitely also forbidden, even without dancing. That kal vachomer, this learning that one is more severe than the other, the music is worse, more happy, brings you more happiness than the dancing, is not so understood because dancing, you pick up yourself and you go on your feet and you start jumping, that's an act of happiness. But once a person just sits on his seat and he listens to music, that's not necessarily bring so much happiness. And therefore, in Sefer Asher Ish, Rav Eliashiv, and also Moshe, brought down in Masoret Moshe, write that the real reason is because already that's the minhag. The minhag, the custom is to forbid hearing music this time, not because of the kal vachomer from the Magen Avraham. Therefore, they say like this, the custom, the minhag became that during the year, one is mekel. But on this time, the custom is to be osel. Forbid music at this time. And this is how almost everybody say that it's asur. Music at this time will be asur. This is how Chacham Ovadia says that the minhag is to be asur. The Or Lezion says that it's asur. So therefore, everybody today at this time forbids hearing music because of the reason we said. First of all, there's strong reasons to say that music should be asur all the year round. as the Achronim wanted to say. And even if we want to say that the Minhag is like the Rishonim we mentioned before, that music should be allowed, but the Minhag is already at least at those times of Sfirat Omer and Yemei Ben HaMetzarim to say that music should not be allowed. So, when we come into that halacha of which music is mutar at the time of Ben HaMetzarim and which ones are asur, we need to differentiate between music that comes for enjoyment and music that doesn't come for enjoyment. And the meaning to this is the following. First of all, we need to know that when we're dealing with a little kid that's under the age of chinuch, educating him to mitzvot on a higher level, so that which comes around the age of 6 and 7, under that age, a kid is allowed to hear music. So therefore, a mother or a father could put the music for her little kid to hear and enjoy. Even though the father or the mother hears it also, but their intention is not to hear the music. Therefore, we said before that whenever it's not your intention, such a thing will be allowed. So it comes out, music for little kids are allowed. Also, you have those that need the music. They're depressed. They feel unhappy. They need to the music to elevate them. Such people also allowed to hear music because, again, the music is not to make them happy. It's to take them out from the sadness they have. Such a thing will be allowed. You have sometimes a person that teaches music or a teacher that has little kids, like we said before. They're also allowed to have music and to put music. They're allowed to play the music if they're teaching music. A person that learns how to play the guitar, the piano, he's learning. If he's learning, says Rav Moshe, to have parnasa, to bring money to the house, that's the reason he's learning. He's allowed to learn at this time. Rav Shmuel Kamenetsky allowed altogether, even not for that intention, since when a person is learning, he's not busy enjoying the music, he's busy learning. Therefore, such a thing, he says, it would be okay. Sometimes a person walks into the store, there's a loud music over there. He goes to the doctor's office, there's music over there. He walks into the bus, there's music. Is he supposed to ask the secretary, the store owner, please put it down, I can't hear the music now? No, the poskim say you don't need to do that. You can go in and shop regular, and you don't need to worry about the music. As long as you don't have intentions to enjoy the music. You're not intending to benefit from the music. You're not starting to sing together with the music. That's fine. As long as the music is there and you didn't turn it on yourself, that's fine. Also, a person that is driving, he needs to wake up. He knows he's driving for a long time. If he doesn't have music, he might fall asleep. That's dangerous. He's allowed to put the music on to keep him up. Rav Shmuel Kamenetsky writes more than that. If a person, for instance, exercises, he needs for the exercise the music. Otherwise, after a couple of minutes, he's falling asleep already. He can't move anymore. So then he puts the music, he can keep on going. The reason he puts the music is not to enjoy it, is to keep him going. That's the same as those people that the Gemara speaks about, that they're pulling the sheep, they're pulling those boats with the ropes. And therefore, the music, Ravuna said, is a positive music over there. They're allowed to have the music. Why? Because they need it for their job. It's other people that show the cows where to go in order to plow the ground. You need them to go in a straight path. And therefore, you put music over there, and they listen to the music, they enjoy it, they go straight. That kind of music is allowed, says Rav Huna. The only music that's asur is a person works, he doesn't need the music. He's working anyway, so what does he put it? He puts it to enjoy himself, to have a good time. That's forbidden. But the other music is fine. So therefore, over here also we're learning that a person needs it for exercise, a person needs to run, that would be allowed. A person needs it for the car driving, it's allowed. So one needs to differentiate when is it allowed and when is it not allowed. When we come to the point of knowing exactly, one needs to see and decide, is this needed because I like the music, I want the music, I enjoy the music, then he should forbid it. But if a person needs it for another intention, he needs to learn, and all of a sudden there's a lot of noise. So he puts himself some earphones with music, that he doesn't listen to the music because he's busy learning, but it interrupts all the noise that's outside. Such a thing would be allowed. There's another topic, big topic, called acapella. Acapella is a big topic, and we need to know, first of all, that the word acapella comes from the word a capella, from the church. Capella is a church. What did they do in the church? in the church, they have over there a band of singers, men, ladies, and they sing together. But since they only have a piano over there, so therefore they need to have all kind of background music together with the band that they're having. So that group of people makes a soberly, it's all kind of different voices. That those voices come and blend together with the person singing, and therefore such a thing comes out and is heard much nicer. Such a thing is called a cappella. Today, the Jewish world took that concept and became already a very wide into the music world. And therefore, in this time, people are hearing the a cappella all over. We need to know that there's different levels of a cappella. Lubelsky explains the following. There's a cappella that one takes the voice and through modifying it in the computer makes it sound a little bit different. All of a sudden, the voice that he said has now a different kind of voice, something that was changed and modified in the computer. That's not anymore a voice of a person. That's already much closer to an instrument that one is not allowed to hear at this time. So therefore, this should be also forbidden. This other a cappella, then what do? They take the voices and they make it very high or very low. They also modify it, they change it. Such a thing also is not the natural voice, should be also avoided. There's other ways that they do today that's very interesting. There's a person singing, or more than one person, and then you have the other people in the band, and what do? They make all kind of different voices. One makes a voice of a drum, another one guitar, another one piano, or whatever's needed. And all of a sudden you hear a whole band behind you playing. It's not real. It's only voices. But those voices make believe that you have the real instruments. That thing is defeating the purpose. What was the whole reason we don't hear music at this time? Because it brings happiness. What's the difference if you get the happiness through music or you get it through voices that makes exactly the same thing? And therefore, since there's no real difference, all the poskim forbid such a thing. You're not allowed to hear to listen to such thing. If a person wants to hear, maybe it will be allowed only if he hears chazanut. A person does chazanut, or a person sings a solo, or even another person sings with him. That's a one voice, but there's no band behind. There's no people that modifying the voices, and there's no changes into it. That could be, it's okay. It's also not that everybody agrees to that, but Moshe says it's okay to hear a voice on the tape, on the CD, on the radio. But once you put it on the tape, like we're saying, that those that don't want to be matir, Rav Eliashiv and Shevet Alevi said, that's exactly like an instrument, because once you take the voice and you put it into a tape, or you put it into a CD, that CD is an instrument, just like a guitar, that would be an instrument. You're right, you hear over here a voice, but that voice through the CD, through the radio, that becomes like an instrument, and not anymore the live voice. And therefore, they said it's a suf. If one wants to be lenient like a Moshe and hear chazan singing, that's fine. But as long as you don't have those voices of the a cappella behind singing in such a way. So we have sometimes leniencies and sometimes not. But we need to know that at least when we come and we are lenient throughout the year, at least at this time we need to know we need to be machmir. And the reason for that is in the time of the Omer, Sfirat HaOmer, we lost 24,000 giants, the students of Rabbi Akiva. The whole Torah came down from five students of Rabbi Akiva that were left after this loss of the big students. But imagine how much more Torah we would have if we would have not 24,000. That's how much Torah we lost, and therefore that's worth mourning over. Not only that, at the time of Ben HaMetzarim, we had the destruction of Bet HaMikdash. So therefore, the Bet HaMikdash is worth at least that minimal time to mourn over. Therefore, this time one should be very careful not to hear music at that time. And if one needs to, only the leniencies we said before. If one not sure, ask a rabbi, make sure. But don't be lenient on more than the Torah or the Chachamim allowed.